G'day, welcome back to Buildsum, and this is going to be the fourth video in my estimating series. And in the first three, we looked at some different scenarios with ridges. And this one, we're going to start looking at the hip of a hip and valley or a broken hip and valley roof. So if you have a look on the plan, our hip always bisects an external corner and generally 45 degrees, and that's what we're going to assume in this case. And this will also apply to valleys as well. So in this case, our building's 7 metres, 572 long. We've got a 600 mil eave overhang all the way around. And we've got a span of our building. I'll just put the walls in so you can see that. So the outside of our timber frame, regardless of whether there's a brick veneer or not, the outside of our timber frame is 5 metres. That'll just make my calculations nice and easy later on. And as I said, 6 metre overhang all the way around. So we're trying to work out the rough length for estimating purposes of the hip. So that's that member there. And then of course there's four of them on this roof. So the first thing we need to know is we need to know how far the roof rises. So we're going to work it on a metre basis. So we're going to work out the rise of the roof per metre. And all we need to do for that is we tan the roof pitch. So in this case, tan 30, the roof pitch for this roof is 30 degrees. So tan 30 will give you a rise per metre of 0.577 metres, or you know, half a metre, 577 millimetres. That's the rise. So every metre that the roof runs, it rises 577 millimetres. So that's the first thing we need to know. Then we need to know how far the hip actually runs per metre. So I'll put that calculation up. So if you do a metre squared, do Pythagoras, do a metre squared plus a metre squared, you'll get obviously 2 metres, and you square root 2 metres, you'll get an answer of 1.414. And that's a pretty common measurement in roofing calculations. So basically what that means is for every metre this way, that on plan runs 1.414 metres. So now we know that our hip, for every metre this way, or you know, that's sort of going along the line of our half span, but for every metre this way, it rises 577 mil, and it runs 1 metre 444. So now we can do Pythagoras again with those two dimensions. So the true length of the hip per metre is 1.414 squared plus 0.577 squared, and do you know, find the answer, square root that, and you get a length of 1.527 meters. So for every meter that the building goes this way, or every meter along our half span, the hip rises 1.527 meters. So now we know that's constant for every roof that's a 30 degree pitch. That is a constant measurement that will always apply. The only thing that's going to change is the half span of the roof. So now what we do is we grab the half span and we times it by the that true length of the hip. Now, just to make the calculation easier, we can also add our eave width in here because we're looking for the overall length of the hip right out to this corner. So half span plus our eave width times by our true length of the hip per metre will give us our answer. So 2.5 is our half span, half of 5, plus 600, which is our eave overhang, times by 1.527 gives us a distance of 4.734 metres. So rounding up to timber orders, we would order a 4.8. Now just something to be really aware of, there's not much of a round up there. We're talking about rounding that up, you know, 66 mil. It's not a real big roundup. So because we know we're going to cut an angle on our hip, here's our plumb cut hip up here, the interesting thing that happens down this end is we end up not having enough material. So depending on what you're going to do with the end of your hip, some people actually cut the overhang of the hip off a little bit, or they reduce the width because they want it to match their rafter size, but other people don't. So It depends on what your preference are, what the people doing the work's preference are, whether you stick with the 4.8 or whether you want to round up to the next size. All right? The next size would be a 5.1. So just something to be aware of. If your roundup is not very much, then maybe you want to round up to the next size. All right, to stop that little phenomenon happening. So what I've also done, if you're interested, I'll put a link in the comments. I've done a quick little spreadsheet. So with this spreadsheet and all my spreadsheets, all you do is just fill in the yellow parts, and the green parts will give you your answers. So this is the same calculation that we just looked at. So 30 degree pitch, 2.5 meter half span, 600 mil overhang. So it gives us our rise per meter of the roof, our length of the hip per meter, overall length of the hip, and which is going to be the total length of the hip. And it gives us an orderable length and how many we need to order. So one at 4.8, but obviously, you know, you need to go around and count the number of hips that you've got on the roof. So there you go. That is a quick way on how to estimate the length for a hip. If you want to work out the exact cutting length, I'll also include some links to some other videos that I've done on actually working out the exact cutting length of a hip using some various different methods. G'day again, I'm back. Just to let you know, if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.